Hey everyone, it's Southern Belle Canto. Welcome back to my channel. Today I will be doing a review. The book that I am reviewing today is Bringing Down the Duke by Evie Dunmore. My spice rating for the book is a 2.5 out of 5, so it has some moderate sex scenes. And my Goodreads rating for this book was a 5-star review. It was wonderful. I highly enjoyed it. So the book is set in 1879, I believe. Let me check. Yes, 1879. So the late 1870s, which I think it goes to 1880 in the end. And this is during the Victorian era, which I really enjoyed. Most historical romances are written in the Regency era, so this was a nice, I guess, twist, moderation for the typical historical romance. We had a wonderful heroine. Her name was Annabelle Archer, and an aspect I really enjoyed about this book was some history and involvement in the suffragette movement. So Annabelle is a suffragette, which I thought was really cool, really exciting. And so a lot of the book deals with her life wanting to help with women's rights to votes, women's rights in general. She is excited because at the very beginning of the book, she is finally able to attend Oxford University before women couldn't attend because, you know, being a woman, you had restrictions you just couldn't break because of your gender and sex and all that. So, yeah, she sadly couldn't attend college until I believe it was 1878. So that was, you know, timing was everything for her. So she's about 25 years old, and sadly, she seems to have been an only child. They didn't discuss other siblings. And because she was a woman, when her father passed away, all of his money, all of his land, estate, blah, 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 everything that was his didn't pass to her since she was a woman. It was passed to her, I guess it was her next of kin that was male, which was a cousin. So instead of being a lady of her house, you know, growing up of a certain wealth class, you know, she's, I would have to say she's upper class because you just couldn't do the things you wanted to do if you were middle class, sadly. Oh, well, maybe middle class. But either way, her cousin is the one that is ahead of her estate, and she essentially becomes an indentured servant kind of to him. She's basically a maid in her own household, if that makes sense. So life for her is not great, and she really wants to go to Oxford. Well, she gets involved with the suffragette movement, and she's making fast friends. And after one of their meetings, they're told by the leader to go out, find men of nobility and influence, and give them these packets, these tracts about women's rights and women's rights to vote, and, you know, help get the word out. We need help. We want men on our side. Well, she, Annabelle, is very brave most of the time, and she bumps into a man with a very, a very nice meet cute. She meets our hero, who is the Duke of Montgomery, Sebastian. So Sebastian is a very young duke, essentially. He was 35 in the story. He became a dukedom. He came to his dukedom, I guess, at the age of 19 after the passing of his father. So he was quite a young duke, and still at 35, it's very young as well. And he is on his way to have a meeting with Queen Victoria, who she's only in the book very shortly, but oh my gosh, if they ever make a movie of this or a TV show, I love Queen Elizabeth. I think she's so, she's not really sassy, but I like her kind of decorum. I don't know how to describe that. You know, the Victorian era was very constricted, but I feel like Victoria, I don't know, you kind of get this idea that she really liked this restriction, but she was also kind of like over it, I think, later in life. Probably not, but that's how I felt. Well, anyway, she has the meeting with our hero, Sebastian, and he wants him to be the head of the Tory party, which is the party that does not want to give rights to women. So we have a big conflict here. We have the heroine meet her hero. She's a suffragette. He is a duke, and he's supposed to be the head of the party that's trying to, like, shut down the women's rights and suffragettes. So, as you can bet, a lot of ups and downs happen for our hero and heroine. I really loved the banter between Annabelle and Sebastian. There was just a lot of fun and like a lot of humor between the two. It wasn't really, I wouldn't say it was an enemies to lovers romance, but you could definitely tell they got on each other's nerves for a lot of it. And I kind of like that in a romance. I like knowing that it's going to be an HEA most of the time or happy for now. But I like that sort of banter and bickering, I thought it was fun. And then there's a lot of nice romance, some really good steamy parts, but I really enjoyed the aspect of the suffragette movement being mentioned, and I'm assuming it's mentioned more in this book series. I believe this is a series. There is the second one, which is A Rogue of One's Own, and the third one just came out, which is either The Portrait or A Portrait of a Scotsman, and they're all in this series called A League of Extraordinary Women, which I just think is so cool. If you're a fan of the movie Suffragettes, you're just gonna love this book. I loved it all in all. It was just a really good romance. I said earlier in a vlog I did that I wondered if this would be similar to a traditional historical romance since this is sort of a new marketing idea. It's the large floppy paperbacks. Now, on the back, it does market it as historical romance, but just like it not being in that mass market form and the cover being different, I wondered if it would be stylized different in the writing. But all in all, I thought it was a traditional historical romance, which I like. And I think this is a clever ploy to get people that are like, oh, historical romance or romances. No. And they see this and they think it's, either women's fiction or generalized fiction or historical fiction, but really, historical romance. It was wonderful. Yes, this was a 5-star read for me. I will absolutely be picking up the second and third books in the series, either in an upcoming haul or because it's getting late in the year, I need to have ideas for friends and family for Christmas ideas. So I might have to save it for Christmas, but I will definitely be reading and reviewing the second and third in the series. As I said before earlier, the movie Suffragettes, starring Carey Mulligan, that's a great movie. I would watch it maybe with this book as a companion for fun. Now, Suffragettes is a drama. It's not romance at all. It's dramatic, but it gives some really good backstory and history for the women's movement and women's suffragette, especially in England. That is set in England, as is Mary Poppins. If you remember the mom from the 1960s movie, she's a suffragette, women's rights. So, I would definitely recommend reading this book. And if you have a Netflix subscription, Suffragettes is playing on Netflix. Just look up in the search either Suffragettes or Carey Mulligan, the lead actress, and that should give you the movie. So, yeah, I either watch that with conjunction. Definitely read this book. So much fun, romance, humor, lots of humor. I definitely recommend. So, yeah, Bringing Down the Duke by Evie Dunmore. 5 stars. Absolutely loved it. Hope you do too. Don't forget to like and subscribe as well as comment. I love comments. I love to hear back from you. I love to hear recommendations. I love to hear if you like the book, if you hated it, that's fine too. I like discussion. I was an English major, so I'm down for all types of discussion. I think it's fun. I like to know why people didn't like stuff, to be honest. I think it's interesting. So please like, subscribe, and comment. As I said earlier, you can also follow me on Instagram at Southern Bell Canto, the same as here, and also on TikTok at Southern Bell Canto. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I will see you soon for another review or another book haul. Maybe that's coming soon. Shh. Bye. Have a great day.